Hello guys, once again welcome back to my channel Mariner Sian. So guys, if you are new to this channel guys, press the subscribe button and press on the bell icon for future notification. So guys, the topic for today is Framo pump. The Framo system is used in the chemical tanker for discharging the cargo out of the cargo tank. I am showing you the Framo system on the right hand side here, where you can see the Framo system very clearly. So guys, you can see the picture on my right hand side very clearly. The bottommost part is the double bottom tank and above it is the cargo tank. So it is basically in the cargo tank where the Framo pump is located. So in the cargo tank inside, it is going to be something like this. Sorry guys, if you are not understanding it, you will get to understand more once you see the Framo pump very clearly. So guys, the Framo pump is something like this. And the pump is over here, you can see it very clearly. So guys, this is your hydraulic motor where you can see it very clearly, and it is a single stage centrifugal pump, vertical type of centrifugal pump. So guys, don't worry, I am not just making you see the pictures, I will be speaking about it in a descriptive sense as the video unfolds. So now talking about the advantage of having Framo pump. The main advantage of having Framo pump is that you eliminate pump rope out of the equation, so you have one hazardous area less. Now I have heard from certain chief engineer that Framo pump is not only available in chemical tanker, but it is also available in crude oil tanker and product tanker. Guys, if you disagree or you have different opinion, comment down in the comment section. It will be a learning platform for us to learn and track different topics. So guys, comment down in the comment section. Second advantage of having Framo pump is that the pump room is eliminated. As the pump room is eliminated, that much of volume or space can be used for holding cargo. As you have more space and volume, you can hold more cargo in it. So basically, that's what owner want. Owner want maximum cargo to be stored inside the cargo tank so that he get profit. So this is the suction bell mouth from where the Framo pump take the suction. You can see very clearly that the Framo pump is located at the bottom of the cargo tank from where it take the suction. As the Framo pump is located at the bottom of the cargo tank, you will be always getting positive suction head, and there is no point in arguing the fact that NPSH, that is net positive suction head, is required. Till the tank become empty, the Framo pump is going to have positive suction head. The picture that you are seeing on the right side of me is the Framo pump, the typical drawing of Framo pump. You can see how the cargo is going towards the discharge side through the discharge pipe. The small diameter pipe next to the discharge pipe, it is the stripping pipe. And the small diameter pipe opposite to the stripping line is the cofferdam purging line. Don't worry anything about it, I will be discussing all the line very clearly as the video unfolds. The red line that you are seeing is the pressure line. So basically, on board a ship there is hydraulic pack. So we will be discussing about the hydraulic system as we move through. The power pack is the one which provides high pressure for driving the hydraulic motor. So basically, the power pack is located inside the engine room or maybe on the deck side, that is poop deck side. The red line that you are seeing is the high pressure line. So basically, high pressure line, the high pressure will be around 180 to 240 bar. So it varies from ship to ship. You have to check your particular high pressure line pressure. So you can see the red color pipeline, which is the high pressure pipeline. So basically, the high pressure hydraulic oil inside it will go and drive the hydraulic motor inside the cargo tank. And you can see the return line, which is the yellow line, which will be coming back to the power pack in the engine room or maybe on the deck side, that is the poop deck side. So the pressure of the hydraulic oil after driving the hydraulic motor will be around 7 bar. 7 bar hydraulic oil will come back through the low pressure pipeline, that is the yellow pipeline, towards the manifold, and through the manifold it will be passing through filter and oil cooler, and through that it will be going to overhead tank, that is the hydraulic oil tank, and from the hydraulic oil tank it will be coming back to power pack, where again the pressure will be boosted to around 180 to 240 bar, and again this hydraulic oil will be going to drive the hydraulic motor present inside the cargo tank. So basically, it circulates and circulates. That's how the cycle functions. And yeah, we have got feed pump for maintaining the level in the hydraulic oil tank. So basically, this feed pump keeps on running and maintain the level in the hydraulic oil tank. The pipeline, shaft, impeller, pump entirely are made of stainless steel. And yeah guys, now we will be talking about the seal present in the Framo pump. That is a seal basically present to prevent the leak from the hydraulic oil side and from the cargo side. Now talking about the material of the seal, it is Teflon. The blue part that you are seeing is the cofferdam. It is the place where you detect leak. And this particular cofferdam space is ventilated to the atmosphere. Guys, you can see very clearly from the picture that the hydraulic high pressure line, that is the red line, is located inside the low pressure return line from the hydraulic motor, that is the yellow line. So basically it will be in this manner. You can see very clearly. The same picture is in my right hand side. And guys, now talking about the Teflon seal part, we will be talking about it in a much more descriptive sense so that it will be easy for you to understand. Basically the type of seal we are using is lip seal. Basically there are two seals which separate the cargo side and the hydraulic oil side. So basically there will be one seal present at the hydraulic oil side, there will be another seal present at the cargo side. So how will you come to know which seal is leaking at which time? So we will come to know very easily through cofferdam. So if the hydraulic oil side seal is leaking, we will come to know through cofferdam. In the cofferdam there will be traces of hydraulic oil. So basically we can come to know the traces of hydraulic oil in the cofferdam by cofferdam purging line. If the cargo side seal is leaking, then we will find traces of cargo in the cofferdam and we can identify by cofferdam purging line, which is very easy. The same happens in two cases and there are no chances and very rare chances that both the seal will leak at the same time, and it is very rare chance. Any of the one seal will be leaking. If you are lucky enough, two seal will be leaking at the same time. The seals are actually present to distinguish the hydraulic side and the cargo side, that is hydraulic oil side and cargo side. You can see a port at the top of the system, that is on the cofferdam purging line. Through that purging line, you will be pressurizing the line through IG or maybe compressed air. So once you pressurize the line, the traces of oil in the cofferdam will be purging out of the line towards the opening, and you can collect the sample and test it whether which seal is leaking. If you get the sample of cargo oil, obviously the cargo side seal is leaking. If you get the sample of hydraulic oil, obviously the seal in the hydraulic oil side is leaking. So obviously any one seal will be leaking. In short, the process is done, that is the purging of the line is done so as to check the integrity of the seal. Yes, now we will be talking about the stripping line. The cargo level in the tank is keeping on dropping, then there will be a time when the pump will lose suction. And as the pump loses suction, the cargo will be present only at the discharge pipeline side. The cargo will be staying there at the discharge pipeline side as no more cargo is being pushed outside as the pump lost its suction. If the pump is stopped, then entire cargo in the discharge line will fall back to the cargo tank. So there is no point in thinking about stopping the pump. So we should keep the pump running. The entire discharge line is filled with cargo, and we should find some other alternate way to take out that cargo from that discharge line. So what is the other alternative way? So the other alternate way is using the stripping line. We will be using the stripping line so that the entire cargo from the discharge line is coming out from that particular line and it is being discharged outside. First of all, we will be closing the discharge valve located at the discharge pipeline. Then we will be opening the cork pressure and the stripping line. Then we will pressurize the entire discharge pipeline in which the cargo is filled by either nitrogen or maybe compressed air. So you can see the pressurizing port present at the top. That is the place where we will be pressurizing the entire line by using nitrogen or maybe compressed air. Once we compress the entire pipeline, that is the discharge pipeline, the cargo won't go inside the tank as the pump is running. So the entire cargo on the discharge valve, rather than falling back into the cargo tank by gravity, it will be coming towards the discharge side by stripping line, by the usage of compressed air or maybe nitrogen in case of chemical tanker. So basically the entire cargo will be coming towards the discharge line via stripping line. On the other side of the discharge valve, the entire discharge will be done. So you can see that picture very clearly on my right hand side. And now talking about the anti-rotation brake located in the Framo pump. Basically what it does is that it prevents the pump from rotating in the opposite direction. In chemical tanker, we use the same pipeline, that is the discharge line, for loading as well as unloading. So basically, while loading is being done, if we don't have drop line, if loading is being done, then obviously the cargo will be coming through the discharge line and it will be having an impact on the impeller. So if the impact is done on the impeller, obviously it will be rotating in the opposite direction as the flow is being reversed. I think we have learned a lot about Framer pump. I think it is enough for today. I hope this video was informative for you guys. Guys, if you have any comment or any question, you can comment down in the comment section. We will be having interaction as well. So guys, subscribe my channel and press on the bell icon for future notification. Guys, see you all once again.